Welcome guys, today with the help of this presentation I'll be explaining the design of retaining wall as per BS 8110. So in this lecture I'll be taking a cantilever retaining wall where I'll be checking that retaining wall against sliding, overturning and your earth bearing pressure, and also I'll be designing the reinforcement of that retaining wall. So before getting into the problem statement, let's get back to what exactly is your retaining wall, what is the function of your retaining wall, and what are the components of your retaining wall. So with the help of this diagram I'll be just discussing what is your retaining wall. This retaining wall is the function of this retaining wall is to retain the earth on any side. Like if you have earth on this side, you have a soil mass on this side, and you don't want that soil mass in this side because you need to construct something, so you need to retain the soil structure on this side. It should not come on this side. So the function of retaining wall is to retain the soil mass. So the retaining wall is divided into two parts. We have this stem, the upper part of this retaining wall is your wall or stem, and the lower part, this is your lower part, which is your base. Again, this base is divided into two parts. We have a toe and heel, because since the pressure on these two points are different, so we will be designing differently. This toe will be designed with different movement, and this heel will be designed with different movement, and this stem will be designed with different movement. So this is exactly what is the function of retaining wall and what are the components of retaining wall. So let's get back to the problem statement. So in this problem we have to design a cantilever retaining wall which I have already shown, which is backfilled with a granular material. Having the soil is a granular material having a unit weight. The unit weight of soil is 19 kilonewton per meter cube, and an angle, internal angle of friction phi of 30 degree, assuming that the allowable bearing pressure of the soil is 120 kilonewton per meter square, the coefficient of friction 0.4, and the unit weight of reinforced concrete is 24 kilonewton per meter square. This unit weight of concrete is mostly constant, so we will be working with these parameters, these soil parameters. So these soil parameters will be given by your soil investigation report, your geotechnical investigation report. So these are the very important parameters which will be defining the design of your cantilever retaining wall or your foundations. So in this problem we have to determine the factor of safety against sliding and overturning, calculate ground bearing pressure, design the reinforcement of the wall. So basically, if you have a retaining wall, any type of retaining wall, you have to consider three checks. Those three checks are very important. The first check is the check against sliding. We have a check against sliding, we have a check against overturning, then we have a check against ground bearing pressures. So these, even if they don't ask for these two calculations, then also you need to consider these three parameters, this sliding, overturning and bearing pressure. So irrespective of asking in the question, you have to consider these three parameters. So against, if our retaining wall is failing against sliding, then we can provide a shear key at base. But if it is failing in overturning and bearing pressure, then we have to redesign the thickness, we have to provide reinforcement, extra reinforcement as per the design requirement. But if it is failing in sliding, then we can just provide a shear key which will give extra benefit against your sliding. We have to also design the reinforcement in this problem, so that we have considered the FCU, that is grade of concrete 35 kilonewton per meter square, the grade of steel is 500 kilonewton per meter square, and cover of reinforcement. So the cover, the effective cover, the base cover are respectively 35 meter mm and 50 mm. So 35 mm for your wall and 50 mm for your base. So even if they don't give these parameters, then you have to consider, if you are designing, then you have to consider these parameters. If you have to consider the grade of concrete, steel, your cover as per codal provision. And but geotechnical report, the soil investigation report are as per your location, as per that soil strata of that location. So with these things you cannot just assume, you have to get the exact soil data of that region. So let's get back to the problem. So we have an active earth pressure acting on this retaining wall. So we have to find the coefficient of active earth pressure, which is equals to 1 minus sine phi upon 1 plus sine phi. Phi is your angle of internal angle of friction. So that Ka is 1 by 3. So the active earth pressure is equals to Ka into your soil density into your total height. Total height is 5 meter plus 0.4. 0.4 is the thickness of your slab. We have assumed the thickness of slab as base slab as 400 mm and your stem as 400 mm. So we will be designing the stem and your base having a thickness of 400 mm. So this 400 mm is as per your assumption. If this retaining wall fails in overturning, sliding, or your base pressure, then we have to rework these parameters, these thickness. So right now we have just assumed a 400 mm thickness, and for your stem, for your base, so that using these values we will work out the active earth pressure PA is equals to 34.2 kilonewton per meter square. So now let's get back into your first check, that is check against sliding. So if you remember, if your retaining wall is failing in your sliding, then we have to rework. We have to either provide a shear key or we have to increase the size of your retaining wall. So consider the forces acting for sliding, that your force will be like this. Your force will be this way. So that force, the horizontal force on your wall due to backfill, this horizontal force, backfill Fa is calculated as 0.5 PaH. 0.5 is because we have a area triangular force pressure, so that half into base into height. Your base width was your pressure, height is 5.4. So total your horizontal force is 92.34 kilonewton. So this is your sliding force, the horizontal force which will cause sliding to your retaining wall. But to resist that sliding force, we have the weight of self weight of your wall, self weight of your base, then weight of the soil. So these weights have been calculated with the parameters which we have assumed. So thickness of wall we have assumed 0.4, the height of the wall, that is stem, was 5 meter, your density of concrete 24, so it is coming around 48. Similarly, your base 0.4, the width of the base was 0.4 meter, and again grade of concrete is 24 kilonewton per meter cube. So this is your weight of base slab. Then weight of the soil, the soil was retained on this much part, that is 2.9 meter part. So that 2.9 into 5 is your height of the soil, and 19 is your soil density. So this is coming around 275.55 kilonewtons. So total vertical load is 361.9, but this total vertical load won't be acting against sliding. We have to multiply this force with your coefficient of friction. So force, the force against sliding, the force which is resisting sliding is equals to mu w2. Mu is your coefficient of friction, so 0.4 into 361, which is coming around 144.76. So assuming a passive pressure force, we don't have any passive pressure, we have only active pressure, so we don't get any benefit of passive earth pressure. So hence factor of safety is against sliding is 144.76 divided by 144.6 is your resisting force, and 92.34 is your acting force. So the total factor of safety is 1.56, which we have to restrict above 1.5, which is okay in our case. We don't have passive pressure because the soil, there is no soil on the other part. We don't have any soil in this part, so we are only considering active pressure. So this we have considered zero. Now let's move into your next check, that is overturning checks. So for overturning, we'll be calculating the overturning moment. That the overturning moment will be due to that horizontal force which was acting due to the soil pressure. So this force into your lever arm of your triangle is 5.4 by 3, that is base your L by 3. So which will be acting on 5.4 by 3. So the moment, the overturning moment is 166.2 kilonewton meter. So again, there will be some restoring moments which will be acting against your overturning moments. So those restoring moments will be due to the weight of your stem, weight of your base, weight of your soil. So with weight into your liver arm, weight into your liver arm, weight into your liver arm, weight of soil into liver arm, weight of base into liver arm, and weight of stem into liver arm. So the total overturning, restoring overturning moment is 822.5 kilonewton. So again, the factor of safety is your restoring overturning moment divided up by your actual overturning moment, so which is coming around 4.9, which is greater than 2. So these factors of safety, these are restricted by your code, that is IS 8BS8110, IS code, your American code. So these values are fixed by your respective code. So here we are getting factor of safety of 4.9, which is greater than 2. Hence we have satisfied this condition of overturning. If our section, let's get back into sliding. If we have a failure in sliding, then we can also introduce a shear key. Shear key will be like, there will be a shear key below your base, which will be helping against sliding, which I have been talking again and again. So now we are done with sliding, we are done with overturning. Let's go to ground bearing pressure. So ground bearing pressure, we will be having two pressure, the minimum pressure and maximum pressure. The minimum pressure will be at your heel, the maximum will be at your toe. So this is your heel, this is your toe, this is your heel. So let's get into the ground bearing pressure. So moment about center line of base. So about center line of base, we are getting this moment due to your earth pressure, due to your wall, and the summation of total moments at about center line of base is 67.5 kilonewton, and we have total vertical load of 361.9. So we have a ratio m by moment by we don't have a ratio, we will be getting a distance that should be lesser than your d by 6. D is your width of the base and 6 is your conditions. So the condition, we have to satisfy a condition where this m by n, moment by total vertical force, should be less than your d by 6. D is nothing but your base slab width. So m by n is coming around 0.17 meter, and d by 6, d is your base width, which is 4 meter by 6 meter, which is coming around 0.66 meter. So hence we, therefore, the maximum ground pressure occurs at toe, and p toe, which is given by n by 4. This is nothing but n is p, your vertical force, p by 4 is your base width, and we have considered 1 meter strip. So the pressure is nothing but force upon area. Area is 4 into 1 meter. So p upon a, this is m by z. Z is again your BD square by 6. So B is 1, D we have considered 4 meters. So 1 into 4 meters square by 6. That 6 is multiplied by moment. So we have M by P by A, M by Z. So the maximum pressure at toe is coming around 116, which is less than your allowable. As per your soil report, it is 120 kilonewton per meter square. So the maximum pressure at your toe, at your base level, is 116, which is less than. Hence we have satisfied this condition. Now we have to find the minimum also. So P by A minus M by Z. So it is coming around 65. So which is less than your allowable bearing pressure. So we have qualified all the three checks. We have qualified against sliding. We have qualified against overturning. We have qualified against bearing. So now we'll be designing the reinforcement. So let's design the reinforcement. So first we'll be designing the bending reinforcement for the wall. So for that, we have a formula to calculate the horizontal force. Fs is equals to 0.5 ka rho h square. Ka is your active earth pressure, rho is your soil density, height is your 5. So this is your horizontal force on your stem per meter. We are calculating per meter, that's why per meter width we have written here. So design moment at the base of the wall will be gamma f fs h by 3. Fs is your force into h by 3. This is your factor of safety. Gamma f is factor of safety, which is kept as 1.4. so this is your design moment at base wall. So for this moment, we'll be designing the reinforcement. H by 3 is because your area is the pressure area. H by 3 is because your pressure area is 1/3. H by 3 is your pressure area is 1/3 of your total height. So let's get back into the design problem. So effective depth you have to calculate for designing. So assume a diameter of steel. We have already assumed a 20 mm dia bar. So hence the effective depth d, small d, will be your overall depth minus your cover. Cover we have considered 35 mm minus your dia of reinforcement by 2, dia of main reinforcement by 2, which is equals to 355 mm. So the ultimate moment of resistance is equals to mu is equals to 0.156 fcu bd square, where this formula comes from abs 8110. So fcu is concrete grade, b is your 1 meter strip, which is 1000 mm, which is equals to 10 raised to 3 mm. D is your effective depth, which is 355 we have worked out, and this 10 raised to minus 6 is because these all terms are in Newton mm, so we are converting it to kilonewton meter, so we have to multiply by 10 raised to minus 6. The total moment, the ultimate moment of resistance, is coming around 688 kilonewton meter. So since we have the moment of resistance, which is very greater than, which is far more greater than your design moment, so we don't need to provide a compression reinforcement. We will be providing reinforcement for this moment. So since mu we have a greater moment of resistance than your design moment, so no compression reinforcement is required. So let's get into the design of your reinforcement. So we have to work out the value of k. This is a constant, where your moment, your steel concrete grade, your width, strip width, your depth, effective depth. So this is coming around 0.040419. So we have to, with the help of this k, we have to find this z. Z is nothing but the lever arm for your moment. M is equals to pressure into your lever arm. Pressure is nothing but your area. M is equals to force into lever arm. So force is nothing but pressure into area. So this is your area of steel is equals to M upon 0.87 FYZ. This is your lever arm. So this is M is 184.7 into 10 raised to 6 because of kilonewton. We are converting everything into Newton mm. This is coming around 1260 mm square per meter. The area of steel required is 1260 mm square per meter. So we are providing a 20 mm dia bar at 200 center to center. So the area of steel provided is 1570 mm square per meter in near face. Near face is the face which is on the soil, retained soil side. So near face we are providing this reinforcement. So we have to provide a minimum reinforcement on the front face. The front face is on the other side of the soil. So the criteria as per BS 8110 is 0.13% of your area of strip. So 0.13% of B into H. B is 1 meter strip, so that 10 raised to 3 mm. Your D cap, this is your overall depth. This is BH. H is considered as your thickness, because your minimum reinforcement is as per your cross-sectional area, not your surface area. So cross-sectional area is your thickness into your length, your width. So thickness is 400 mm overall depth. This is your D. This is your overall thickness. This H is your overall thickness of stem. So 0.13% B into H, that is 0.13% of 10 raised to 3 into 400 mm, which is equals to 520 mm square per meter. So we are providing 12 mm dia bar at 200 center to center. So area of steel provided is 566 mm square, which is far more greater than your required area. So hence we have provided a two reinforcement on stem, that is your at your near face, which is coming around 1570 mm square, and the front face, which is on the other part of, on other side, so which is coming around 566 mm square per meter. Now let's talk about the design of your heel, that is base, heel and toe. So the pressure at there will be two pressure at your base, there is a different pressure at your heel, there is a different pressure at toe. We have already worked out the maximum and minimum pressure, which when the maximum pressure was 116, the minimum was your 91 kilonewton per meter square. So P3 is coming 142.8 kilonewton per meter. So the design moment at point C, MC, is worked out with the help of this problem. This MC has been worked out, 160.5 kilonewton meter. So the design moment at C is coming around 142.8 kilonewton meter. So let's get back to design. So assuming we have assumed here also, we have assumed 20 mm dia bar, but the cover of reinforcement at your base level is 50 mm. So effective depth in the base will be changed. 400 was your total depth, overall depth minus 50 mm your cover, minus 20 by 2, 340 mm. So again, we are calculating KZ, that is lever arm. So area of steel is coming around 1142. So we are providing 200 mm center to center. So area of steel is worked out 71570 mm square in top face. So we are providing top reinforcement and bottom reinforcement. So the top reinforcement will be your this reinforcement with your maximum pressure. So design moment at point B. So we are calculating the point B is your toe part. This point B for your toe part. This toe part. This is your toe. This is your heel. So design moment for, again, we'll be working out the design, the moment at point B. So which is coming around 36.5 kilometers. So area of steel is coming around 260. We are providing minimum steel reinforcement, that is 520 mm per meter square. 520 mm square per meter. So hence we have provided same reinforcement which we have provided in the stem. We are providing 12 mm dia bar at 200 center to center spacing, which is coming around 566, which is greater than minimum reinforcement criteria 566 mm square in bottom face of the base slab and distribution steel at the base slab. So this is the reinforcement detail. This is the reinforcement detail. This is your front face. This is your front face, and this is your near face. Near face is on the soil side, and this is the front face. So the front face, near face, top reinforcement, bottom reinforcement. So we have provided all the reinforcement, front face, near face, top reinforcement, bottom reinforcement. So hope this design of a retaining wall as per BS 8110 is clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can come with your doubt. You can comment in our section. We will be trying to clarify your doubts, and we'll be explaining those queries. So hope you have understand this lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day. Take care. Goodbye.